Hello dear friends, in this video we will make an example level with what we learned earlier. What we learned in previous videos. Moving obstacle. Scene design by using Tilemap. Teleport system. Respawn and checkpoint. Area effector. Moving platform. Lighting system. And more. Today, we will create a level using all of these. Friends, this is a practice video. If you haven't watched the previous videos of the series, you cannot understand some points. You can find a detailed video of the subject you don't understand on the channel. Okay, let's get started. First, I wanna create a new scene. Right click on the project panel. Create and click on scene. Rename it. Open the scene. As you can see, there is only a camera object in the scene. I will delete this camera and add the camera object I created earlier. Open prefabs folder. The prefabs are here that we created earlier. You can easily use an object you created prefab whenever you want. Drag and drop the main camera prefab to the hierarchy panel. Let's create wall by using Tilemap. We created the Tilemap prefab in previous video. I will change workspace layout. Open tile palette window and I'll close the hierarchy panel. Now I'm gonna draw walls by using the tile palette. Okay, the walls are ready. Back to previous workspace layout. You can customize workspace layout as you want. I'm gonna add background to the scene. Open sprites folder and drag and drop the background image onto the scene. Increase the scale of the background. You can change the color of the background. And I will set the sorting layer as background. Open prefabs folder again. Let's add the player to the scene. Start the game. As you can see, the camera is going down a lot. We can limit the movement of the camera with camera controller script. We can set its limits by moving the camera. Start the game again. I'm gonna add moving spike to the scene. I will enable magnet tool to make positioning easier. I will duplicate the spike object with Ctrl D shortcut. I want them to move in opposite directions. So I'm gonna do a small update to the second spike object. Looks better. Let's add fixed obstacle to the scene. I wanna disable the line of the camera. Duplicate the spike object. rotate the spike object. Duplicate. As you can see, there are lots of spike objects in the hierarchy panel. I'm gonna create an empty object named spikes. Then I'll drag and drop all spike objects to this empty object to keep simple the hierarchy panel. I will add area effector object here so the player can go up. Start the game. I'm gonna add portal here. Let's add moving square here. Set the position. I wanna add moving platform to here. I wanna decrease the platform scale. And I will set the movement path of the platform. Duplicate the platform. Start the game. Let's add checkpoint here. Let's add light to make the scene more attractive. First, I will add the global light to the scene. Right click on the hierarchy panel, light and global light 2D. With the target sorting layer, you can determine the layers that the light will affect. You can change the intensity of the light. I will add spotlight to the scene. I will activate the shadow cast feature of the light. I will add shadow caster to tile map. As you can see, the shadows of the walls are now forming. You can change the strength of the shadow. I will duplicate the light. I wanna add light to the player. Drag and drop onto the player. Adjust the light of the player. Let's create finish point in the next videos. When the player reaches the finish point, the level is completed and the next level is loaded. And we will create a UI for the game. In the next video, I will add music and sound effects to the game. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.